Hello, my fellow gearheads. Today I'm here with a quick look at my latest set, which is this Ford Mustang Shelby GT500, and the number is 42138. On the back of the box you can see the Ford Mustang Shelby GT500 with the covered rear, which is the regular pullback mode, and this is the play mode with the foot trigger. Here are just some pictures about the AR experience and how to play with the pullback, and picture of the real Ford Mustang. And here are some other images that you can see. And that's pretty much it. Official licensed sticker over here. And yeah, let's open the box and see what's inside. So altogether we have two bags that are numbered number one, two bags that are numbered number two, two loose pullback motors, a sticker sheet, and the building instructions. Here is a simple explanation how to operate the model, and here is just side-by-side comparison of the real Ford Shelby GT500 and the Lego version. I can share with you as well the information that the Ford Mustang Shelby GT500 is actually my 26th model that I designed for Lego Technic, because I worked there for almost 10 years, and it's one of my favorite cars, so I definitely jumped on the opportunity to design one. The model comes with two possibilities on how to build the rear. One of them is the play mode, in which you have the foot trigger that releases afterwards the pullback mechanism, so your hands are free to operate the smartphone with the AR app. And this is the display mode, in which it works as a regular pullback vehicle. To switch in between the modes, it's fairly easy. You just pull on the trigger. Afterwards, you just place this tile section with the Cobra logo, and then you attach this part, and that's pretty much it. And of course, doing the other way around, you just switch it to the play mode. You can play with the model as it is, or you can as well use the Lego Technic AR app, which unfortunately doesn't work on my cell phone, so I can't show you the exact footage, but at least I'm gonna use the official instructions from lego.com. But there's at least one thing I can be proud of, which is if you click the makers, you can see my name over here as the designer of one of the Lego Technic sets. There were many comments about the color of the car, because everybody thinks that the Mustang should be white with blue stripes or blue with white stripes. The only issue with that is that Lego still has this one in the market. And what if you are a parent and grandparent that doesn't know anything about Lego, and your child, spouse, or whoever asks for a blue Mustang? Which one do you pick? There might be a lot of confusion. And I personally as well really like the Grabber Lime. And I think it's a great source of lime green parts that came a year before in the Lamborghini. So you can get them a lot easier right now. There were as well many comments on the proportions of the car not being right, but I think it's actually pretty good. And of course some compromises had to be done, because this car actually goes at like 1200 kilometers per hour, and when it impacts a wall or a corner of a furniture, it needs to be as sturdy as possible. Therefore, this lip really needed to be locked, and it's actually locked at a correct angle compared to the reference. But of course, the drawback of this is that the lights can't be as high as they are supposed to be. Another thing that I notice as well very often is that why are not the tires rotated with these spokes out, because it looks better? Well, yes, it looks better, but they can slide off the axles much easier. Therefore, we need to secure them with the bushes on the end of the axle. So yeah, that's the simple and clean explanation for this. Another comment I read quite often online is that what does this sticker with number 22 mean? Well, actually, I just promised to dedicate this set to my wife, and you can translate it however you want, but there's a hidden message in this, definitely. Many of you might be as well asking, when will I put out the instructions for the steering and V8 mode? Well, unfortunately, the video is way below the views that I expected from it, so just try to share it with your friends, try to watch it, offer it to your community, and maybe the views will get higher, and then I will just publish the instructions for free. But the good news is that I got a brilliant and totally crazy idea for a B model from this one, which I'm gonna try, and let's see if it's gonna work at all. So that should be it from my side. Hope you liked watching the video. If yes, hit the thumbs up button. Feel free to leave a comment. And if you are new over here, just hit the subscribe button at the bottom right corner, and as well hit the notification bell. That way you get notified whenever I upload a new video. So hopefully you liked watching this. Hopefully it was interesting as well to share some of the thoughts behind this vehicle. And that was it. That was the LEGO Technic Ford Mustang Shelby GT500 4:1:38 that I designed as my 26th official LEGO Technic model. Until next time, everybody, stay safe, take care, and bye bye.